myself, Ashish Srivastava, social science teacher of St. Gabriel's High School, Gurugram. Student, today I will explain you third chapter of economics, that is money and trade. This chapter include topics money, barter system, double coincidence of marks, bank, function of bank, function of RBI, trade, collateral, terms of trade, types of trade, debt, SHG, etc. First, I will tell you about money. Money is something that can be used as a medium of exchange. Children, modern form of money include this paper note, coins, which you are using these days. Earlier, when there was not introduction of money, people use different things like titles, grains, etc. for transactions. But these days, money, which is modern form of money, paper note, coins, etc., are running and used in our day-to-day life. In our country, money is issued by RBI on the behalf of central government. No other bank is authorized to issue money in our country. Dear children, money. Now we come back to when there was not an introduction of money. People use different things for exchanging our goods, and this system was called barter system. Even this system, in barter system, there was a problem. The problem was that in barter system, both persons should be agreed to sell or buy each other's goods. When anyone is not agreed to sell or buy each other's goods, then exchanging was not possible. So in barter system, the important fact was double coincidence of wants. That is our third topic, double coincidence of wants. It was the main feature of barter system. Yet again, so double coincidence of the first that in barter system, both persons should be agreed to sell or buy each other's goods. And if anyone is not agreed, then transaction is not possible. I will explain you with one example. Suppose there is a farmer and there is a shoe maker. And farmers need shoes and shoemakers at the same time. The shoemaker also need the production of the farmers. It may be wheat or rice, etc. If shoemaker did not need wheat or rice or any other production of the farmer, then exchanging is not possible. Farmers did not get the shoes. So this is the problem in barter system. Dear children, now I will come back to the topic bank. Children, all of you know about the bank. Bank, I will tell you first about bank. Bank play the role of mediator between those who have surplus money and those who need money. If we have extra money, then we go to the bank to deposit it, and bank also pay some amount of interest on it. And if we need money, then we go go to the bank or payday or loan. Dear children, so bank play the role of mediator, those who have surplus money and those who need money. And when we deposit our money in the bank, bank provide us some amount of interest on it. And when we take the credit or loan from the bank, then bank also charges some amount of interest. And the difference between these interest, whatever bank provide us on deposit and what bank charges on loan is a source of income of the bank. So then bank charges high amount of interest on credit and it provides less interest whatever we deposit in the bank. Clear, children? Now I will tell you about the different types of deposits also. In banks, deposits are two types. One is demand deposit and second is fixed deposit. Demand deposit is what whenever we need money, we can withdraw it from the bank. And fixed deposit, it may be for fixed time of period, 1 year, 2 year, 5 year, etc. Clear, children? Now I will tell you about he who supervise the bank in India. Children, in India, all the banks are supervised by the RBI. That is Reserve Bank of India. RBI takes the care of all the banks. It looks that the banks have currencies or cash or not. If there is a problem in any bank, RBI provide them cash also. And also looks that the banks provide loan to the rich person only or poor also. So time to time we check that the banks provide the loan to the rich people or poor people or what they are interested. Time to time it checks and reduce or increase the rate of interest also. Dear children, now your topic here, concern of banks. And one more feature banks provide, that is a check, system of check. Check, children, about the check. You know, if we have any account in any bank, then bank issue check on the name of any person's account, and this account will also work as a currency. And those people who has had any account in the banks, they can get issued a check by the bank, and check also work as a money. Now, children, we will come to the topic credit. The topic is credit. Children, credit are loans which refers to an agreement in which the lender supplies the borrower money or goods or services with the promise that they will pay in future. And this credit is very common in our day-to-day life. Credit is two types, formal source of credit and informal source of credit. Formal source and informal source. Formal source include banks and cooperatives. Informal source include money lenders, friends, relatives, or whatever we know personally. informal source of credit is not good for poor people, and farmer source of credit is very important. Its area should be increased to provide affordable loan to the poor people. Children, farmer source of credit is very important for the development of borrowers and countries also, because it helps in the infrastructure development of the country. Children, informal source of credit charges very low rate of interest and it is supervised by the RBI. But informal, there is no agency which can check the credit activities of the informal source of credit. So they are free and they exploit the borrowers. Informal source of credit, the lender exploit the borrowers. The problem is that most of the poor people still depend on the informal source of credit because they have lack of collateral. They have lack of collateral. Now I will tell you about collateral. What is collateral? Collateral is something which may be the property of the borrower, their document, their deposits in the bank, their livestock, their houses, which can be used as a guarantee, which can be used as a guarantee by the borrower to the lender, and the lender has the right, the lender has the right to sell the collateral in case of non-repayment of the credit or loan. When loan is not repaid, the collateral can be sold by the lender. So collateral is an important fact which is ruled in the farmer source of credit. The bank will not provide the loan without collateral. But in informal source sector, the lender personally knows the borrower. They become ready to give the loan to the borrowers, and they charge very high rate of interest. In this way, borrowers mostly fell into debt trap. Now I will tell you about debt trap. Debt trap is a situation when borrower is not able to repay the loan, and to repay the loan, the borrower had to sell his property, part of property, to repay the loan. So debt trap is an important feature in our source of credit. Children, the poor people are still depend on informal source of credit. Why? Because they have lack of collateral. And to take a loan from farmer sector, there is a need of documents and different types of paper. So mostly village people, rural people, or poor people are illiterate. They cannot fulfill all the documents. They have lack of collateral. So they do not get a loan from formal sector. So they are depend on the informal source of credit. Yes, children. Now I will tell you credit how help in the development of the borrowers. Children, in poor and affordable rate of credit provided to the people, then it helps in the development of them. They can start their businesses, they run their agricultural activity, they can run any small business. So poor and affordable rate of credit is very important, and government should increase farmer source of credit in rural areas also. Children, now come on the topic. SHG. SHG means self-help group. Children, due to the problem of informal source are created, a new system that is SHG is initiated by the rural people in India. It is now, these days, very popular and especially in the women. It may be run by 20, 25, 15, it may any members, especially women, and they can save monthly some amount of money, like 50 rupees, 25 rupees, 100 rupees monthly. We have regular saving and we have regular meeting. There is a regular saving and there is a regular meeting of the group members. The group members can take the loan from this amount, whatever they deposit in the bank, whatever money is deposited by the SFC members in the bank, only the members of this group can take the loan from this SFC. Here, the rate of interest is very affordable. The rate of interest is very affordable. They can run their small business. They can lease their mortgage lands. They can purchase sewing machine, etc. So it is very helpful for the development of rural women in rural areas. It not only helps them to solve their economic problem, but also this has become the building block of the rural women. It also solve their domestic and social problems also. So then if any member of this group take the loans, and if he help in, he or she help in any problem, then they can use the help of the group members. The group members help the person who has taken the loan after any problem. They help the person to repay the loan. And in all the decision about the rate of interest and any decision is taken by only by the group members. And if the group regularly collect the money, and if there is any account on the name of the SHG in the bank, then if there is a regular saving, then bank consider it as a collateral. Here then, bank consider the SHG as a collateral, and if any member want to take the high loan or high credit, then bank is ready to provide them loan and consider it as a collateral. Dear children, thank you.